Welcome everyone. Very important episode today talking about a truly invasive macroalga known as Starry Stonewort or Nitellopsis obtusa. Now there's not many truly documented invasive algal species out there, but this macroalga is definitely one to keep an eye on. Now it's in the class Caraceae in division Streptophyta like other macroalgae or plants. Starry stonewort produces bulbils, which are asexual structures and the main pathway for the establishment of new plants. Now these are usually star-shaped, hence the name starry stonewort. They can form at nodes in the water column off the main stalk, but I see them often attached to the rhizoids in the sediments. Take a look at these. They can number in the thousands per meter squared. Now, these aren't true roots. These rhizoids anchor them to the bottom, but not true roots like your typical macrophyte plants. Now this species has both male and female types, but only the male types have been documented in the US. And if you're lucky, you can find these small sort of orange spheres on them called antheridia. Those are the male reproductive structures. Now the cell itself is a large, hollow, vegetative cell. They're mostly composed of water and then can be popped and deflated. And it's pretty easy, and that pop test is how I like to identify it in the field. You just pop, squeeze it out, and there's not much left to it, pretty flaccid. Now, also has 4 to 6 branchlets that come off the main stalk. They're arranged in whorls, and they're usually longer than those you see in other macroalgae like Cara. Now, starry stonewort is a desired species in its native range, but it's highly invasive in the US. It's now been documented in literally hundreds of lakes throughout the northern tier of the United States, mostly in the Midwest and Northeast, but modeling suggests that the invasion could spread through at least 29 states through the United States. It can grow in all types of waters, like lakes and ponds, slow-moving rivers, and at depths over 8 meters deep. Now, Nitellopsis obtusa can outcompete most native macrophytes. It can clog fish habitat, fill up the entire water column with huge growths described as pillows. It's very difficult to use the water for anything, even getting your boat out. So keep an eye out for the super invasive macroalga and realize that we at CEPRO have the expertise and solutions to help you manage it if found. So thank you for tuning in to this important and pretty serious episode of Algae Corner on Nitellopsis obtusa or starry stonewort, the invasive macroalga.
If you have a problem with toxic or nuisance algae, CEPRO can help you fix it. Give us a call, visit our website, or take a look at the rest of our videos for more information. Thanks for watching and subscribing to Algae Corner.